They are just so cuddly and they are so sweet.
Not the usual terms you hear to describe a skunk. Stinky, smelly, pests. Julie McLaughlin says, how about the word cute?
I had always heard they make absolutely wonderful pets, and they do. They're very clean, they do not smell.
McLaughlin would know. She and her business partner Rachel run the Indiana Skunk Rescue, the only rescue in the country licensed to help both domesticated and wild skunks. And helping move wild skunks isn't as precarious as you'd imagine.
I take cage and all, and I will put it in the front seat of my car. We hit potholes, we go over railroad tracks. They sleep just like this.
It takes quite a bit to anger a skunk. They're pretty chill. Partly that's due to their incredibly poor eyesight. They can only see a few feet in front of them, but if you do make one angry, it will give you plenty of warning.
They will stomp at you, they will puff all up, they will run backwards and stomp and stomp and stomp, make every hair, you know, stand up on end. Once they turn into a U, that's when they're gonna spray.
And with a squirt reaching 20 feet, it's all over. But not here in McLaughlin's kitchen. Flower and his pal Diana are domesticated skunks. All domesticated skunks, by USDA regulations, must be de-skunked. Running around the kitchen, their main motivation in life is food.
Whatever you cannot give a cat or a dog, you cannot give to a skunk, like grapes and chocolate and onions and the whole list. Skunks also should not eat cat food. They can have grain-free dog food, but not cat food. They're always hungry. Their stomach's like the size of a walnut. They will eat until they throw up. So a lot of people that have domesticated skunks, they love them to death.
Skunks can be litter box trained, although they will pick where the litter box goes. They will also learn their names and come when called. They need to have a burrow in the house somewhere, what McLaughlin calls a fort. And, well, they're little thieves.
Rachel, her skunk Tuna, loves socks. So she likes to steal socks and blankets and go and put them in her fort.
Skunks aren't rodents or weasels. They have their own classification, the Mephitidae. Their closest relative is a kind of badger. But aside from the badger-like stripes, domesticated skunks can come in a variety of colors.
We do an educational thing every Wednesday, and I was telling them that the domesticated skunks, they come in albino, they can come in solid colors, they come in every color that they could imagine. And a little girl stood up and she goes, I want a purple one, I want a purple one.
Skunks can live with other pets in a household, including dogs, but you need to be mindful of the instincts and prey drive of the dog. They're a 10-year commitment and they're simply not allowed as pets in many states.
Skunks are only legal in 17 states. If you get one, make sure you're not gonna be planning on moving in the next 8 to 10 years because you could move to an illegal state and not be allowed to take your skunk with you.
McLaughlin is on a mission to spread understanding about skunks because this is their world too. If you get one as a pet, know what you're in for. If you find one in the wild, leave it alone, she says. If you do need a skunk to be elsewhere, wild or domestic, reach out to your local rescue and there will be a happy ending for everyone. Joy Hernandez for Pet Pals TV.